It's November 3rd, 2006. This is a very special day because it's my 2-year anniversary of being raw. And it's also an important day because it's the 1-year anniversary of my training. I've been training now for a year. And I've made a great deal of progress in that time. A lot of, learned a lot. It's been quite a challenge, quite a roller coaster ride. And I'm not going back. I'm not giving up. I'm not quitting. I'm moving forward. This has changed my life, this experience, this journey, this film. Started out as an experiment. And a year later, it's become my life. This is what I do now. I travel around the country speaking about raw food and athletics. I compete all over the country. I'm writing a book about diet and athletic performance. And I'm making this film. And I've given up all sources of income. I've given up any even desire to look for another job. This has been such a powerful experience for me that I don't want to do anything else. I don't see the point. This is something I'm really truly passionate about at this point. It's no longer just an experiment. It's no longer just a curiosity. It's changed who I am. What has happened to me in this past year and these past 2 years have been mind-boggling. What I'm discovering physically, emotionally, mentally, there's no way you can go back. Once you swallow that green pill, there is no turning back. But at the same time, I now find myself in a position today. I went online to check my bank account, and I found out that I'm broke. So I have no way. I'm in Vermont right now. I have no way of getting back to Chicago to continue my speaking tour. I have no way of paying my rent in Los Angeles, which was due 2 days ago. And I already mailed a check. Bounce. And I don't have any income coming in. And I'm scared and I'm freaking out. And I don't know what's going to happen. But at the same time, this is so important to me. This journey, this mission is so important to me that I don't want to give up on it. And I don't want to have this obstacle stop me from sharing this. I really believe that the impact of what I'm working on is enormous and is going to affect a lot of people very, very deeply. And I don't just want to turn my back on it because things are tough. I don't know what the future holds. I don't know if I'll be kicked out of my place. I don't even know how I'm going to eat or travel, get back to LA, or continue speaking, but I don't have a choice. I don't see the point of doing anything else. It's snowing a little bit. There's the greatest light behind me a few minutes ago. All the dark clouds, dark snow clouds, and the sun was hitting the trees. It was gorgeous.